So today I'll be doing a video discussing huge fairy tale news and why, if you consider yourself a fairy tale fan, you need to be excited for this amazing news, because I will be honest, this might have just been the best news that we have gotten all year for fairy tale. I mean, literally when it dropped, I could not wait to record this video. Like, I'm literally super excited to record this because this is the greatest fairy tale news that we have gotten in a long time. A lot of naysayers have been coming out saying that Hero Mashima wasn't going to do anything, but they have been put to rest. Now, as you guys can see, there will be a new series. Yes, there will be a new fairy tale series coming in October, and boy oh boy, this is just great news, because we find out that it's going to be a weekly, yes you guys heard me right, a weekly crossover series between Fairy Tail, Eden Zero, and Rave Master. And if you guys don't know, if you guys have been living underneath the rock and don't know what those other two series are, Eden Zero, Rave Master, those are both the other series that Hero Mashima has done in the past. Rave Master is the one that he's done in the past, Eden Zero is the one that he's working on currently, and Fairy Tail obviously being the biggest out of those three. Rave Master was actually pretty popular. There's multiple games of it. A lot of people do enjoy it. Some people like Rave Master more than Fairy Tail. Me personally, I haven't finished Rave Master, but I'm still a Fairy Tail fan. I like Fairy Tail the most out of all the three series, but we do find out that we are going to get a crossover between these three series, and it makes sense because we found out that all these series, they all take place in the same world. And I just had to give a round of applause to Hero Mashima because he set that up perfectly. And we also found out that it will be a two-week publication, which that does mean that it will be short term. So it's not like it's going to be like a Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest, which if you're a Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest fan, stay tuned because I have some huge news for you later on. But even though it's going to be just a two-week publication and it's going to be short term, at least we're getting more than one spinoff chapter, because usually with the spinoffs, like the special chapters like this, because if you guys don't know, this is for Weekly Shonen Jump 60th anniversary. This isn't just like it's coming out of nowhere. No, this is a big news. So this is why it's big that they're getting more than one spinoff, because that means that they're going to be running 1 week and then the one after the anniversary. That's why I'm excited to see how they're going to handle the story, what's going to be the plot for this spinoff. I'm excited for it. And we actually got revealed to the name. It will be called Heroes, and like I said, all three of the worlds will be combined. And if you guys did not see the Rave Master and Fairy Tail OVA that came out a while ago, that one was actually pretty interesting because it had the characters interacting, all that stuff. And we can see from the cover alone, it's not just going to have Natsu, Shiki, and I'm drawing a blank at Haru. I'm not a fake fan of Hero Mashima. See, round of applause. But no seriousness, we see that it's Natsu, Shiki, Haru, Rebecca, Lucy, Gray, and just everybody on the cover for Heroes. So I'm excited to see what characters are they going to be adding. Maybe they're going to add Urza and LC Crimson, because yo, Hero Mashima, one of the biggest things, like I guess you could say memes about his artworks, is that he recycles character designs like it's nothing. And I mean, you can't really blame him because they're all his series, Jalal, Siegfried, Jalal, and the person in Eden Zero. But basically, I'm interested to see how they're going to interact, because the Fairy Tail Rave Master OVA, that one was one of the funniest OVAs I've ever seen. And I definitely do think that with all these worlds combined, maybe Hero Mashima can do something that will be super epic. And speaking of epic, Eden Zero will still be going on simultaneously. And yo, this is what I mean when Hero Mashima is the GOAT, because the fact that he's going to be doing Eden Zero while doing this crossover series and Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest goes to show you his workload. And I'm not gonna lie, I do kind of copy it with the other channels. Everybody's already asking, yo, why do you make all these other channels and all this stuff? Hero Mashima can do it, so why can't I? And speaking of Hero Mashima, I just gotta say, he confirmed that there will be original content coming from this series. Yes, there will be 100% original content coming from this series. That means that it won't just be a bunch of random moments like them just meeting up in, like, you know, different parts of the story. No, this is going to be something that takes place, I believe it's going to take place like before the Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest, or maybe after the 100 Year Quest, just so that they can, like, you know, kind of not spoil the series. Me personally, I think they might have the pre-100 year quest because they won't have Dragon Natsu going crazy, but that's either here or there. We found out that there's going to be a 100% canon story for it, and we got a little sneak peek on what we could expect because Hiro Mashima, he just released pictures on Twitter of the pairings. Now, all he did was just show the pairing side by side, like them just Natsu, Lucy, Haru, and his girl, then Rebecca and Shiki, and he also threw in Gray and Juvia. Shout out to one of the best fairy tale pairings in there, but he basically showed us what we could expect from the movie. Maybe it will be a movie pushing the pairings, and if it is, y'all know what that means, that fairy tale next generation greatness, because Hiro Mashima, we know that he is a genius at marketing. So what would be the best way to market fairy tale next generation than having all three of your series coming together? And we also know that Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest is going to be coming, well, I'm not going to say it's coming to an end soon, but it's not going to be as long running as the first fairy tale series, as I should say. So I do think that the fact that Hiro Mashima is throwing the pairings at us early might be a sign at next generation. So all the naysayers that say next generation, that, no, just shut up, because you guys have been proven wrong multiple times, and we see that Hiro Mashima, he's actually going to be taking the story for this spinoff seriously. And I'm actually excited to see what original content comes from this series, because you'll never know, some of it can tie back into the main story of Fairy Tail or the main story of Eden Zero. And if you guys want me to, I will do videos covering Eden Zero. If you guys want me to, let me know in the comment section down below. But I definitely am excited because this will be 100% canon and original content coming from this spinoff. And last but not least, this is personally my favorite part of the news. Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest will become weekly. Yes, yes, yes. Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest will become weekly, but it will only be while Heroes is ongoing. So that means that we will have about 2, if we're lucky, 3 weeks of weekly Fairy Tail content. And I'm just like, yes, 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 this is greatness. Now, the only reason why I'm saying 3, that's just the fanboy and me hoping we get, like, maybe the chapter day falls on, like, you know, an extra day or something, so we get, like, you know, maybe. But in all actuality, it'll probably only be 2 straight weeks of that Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest greatness. And I'm excited because now that Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest will be weekly for 2 weeks, that means that there will be 2 chapters that we will be getting with the ongoing Hero series, and if you are caught up to Eden Zero, that too. And knowing Hiro Mashima's writing pattern, basically there's 2 things that I can expect from these 2 chapters. Either 1, there will be a lot of action, because we know Hiro Mashima, action isn't something that's really his main thing. We see in 100 Year Quest, the action has been phenomenal. It's been some of the best parts in Fairy Tail. But whenever Hiro Mashima does do chapters like these, he does tend to draw the fights. We saw Natsu and Gildarts when he dropped 2 chapters. He basically just had them fighting the whole time for the whole time skip. Or I do think he could do a bombshell chapter, because Hiro Mashima, he loves to drop the huge bombshell when there's 2, basically when he does back-to-back chapters. If you guys have been following the Fairy Tail manga for a while, you would know how crazy Hiro Mashima used to get the Acologia Zerum. Like, it was a time where Fairy Tail was undoubtedly the best ongoing piece of fiction when he was dropping that heat. And I do think that with these 2 100 Year Quest chapters that will be coming out weekly, this is going to be something that will be huge for the Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest series. We're going to get some huge revelations within those 2 weeks. So October, be excited, because correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe the Fairy Tail anime will be done by then. And I definitely do think that this is all a plan to get you guys who are anime onlys into the Fairy Tail manga, because I'm gonna be honest, if you are reading the Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest manga, what are you doing? Like, what are you doing? Like, I understand if you're an anime only, you want to finish out the series, I can respect that. But if you're a true Fairy Tail fan, you just gotta read the 100 Year Quest manga. It is literally, me personally, I think it is better than the previous Fairy Tail series. That says a lot, because we're only 33 chapters in, but yet it's just so much, like, there's just so much greatness. And last but not least, we see Hiro Mashima, he jokingly says that he is not afraid of the workload. flow, because I'm not gonna lie, this is a lot of stuff. Doing Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest weekly, having to do the new spinoffs, and still doing Eden Zero, all that stuff. He actually says that he's excited for Borderlands 3. So hey, if he's with it, I'm 100% with it. I'm excited for it. And if you guys haven't already, follow me on Twitter, because I'm not gonna lie, I'm trying to get into that little spinoff. I want Hero Boss to put me in the spinoff. You know, maybe you might get a little cameo, but no, in all seriousness, I definitely am excited for all this new Fairy Tail news. I definitely think that this is the greatest Fairy Tail news that we have gotten for 2019. And you know, once all this stuff like goes by, Hero Mashima will most likely drop another bombshell right when we think that he's going to be done with all this epic news. Comment what you guys see down below. Subscribe if you haven't. Peace out.